Want to make a sound that turns heads, grabs attention, and sounds like it came straight from a vintage sci-fi movie or an old fire truck? Hey guys, in this video I'll show you how to make a hee-haw siren using the 555 timer IC. Stay tuned to the second part of this video where I'll explain how this circuit works. I've packed my favorite 555 timer projects into a free ebook. Yep, totally free. Don't miss it. Click the link in the description to get yours. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. 2 alligator clips, 10 jumper wires, 1 22,000 ohm resistor, 1 220,000 ohm resistor, 1 2,200 ohm resistor, 1 microfarad capacitor, 1 10 microfarad capacitor, 1 0.1 microfarad ceramic capacitor, 2 555 timer ICs, a 9 volt battery, a 9 volt battery buckle connector, 1 5-watt speaker, a breadboard to connect everything together. The 555 timer IC comes with 8 pins. There is a notch or a dot on the chip's body. Starting from the top left is pin 1, which is ground or the ground supply. Pin 2 is trigger. It is used to start the timing interval in both monostable and astable modes. Pin 3 is output. It delivers the result of the timer's operation based on its mode, either monostable, astable, or bistable. Pin 4 is reset. It is used to reset the 555 timer's internal flip-flop. Pin 5 is control. It allows you to control the threshold voltage levels that the internal comparators use to set and reset the flip-flop. Pin 6 is threshold. It monitors the voltage of the capacitor connected to the circuit. Pin 7 is discharge. It controls the charge and discharge cycle of the timing capacitor. Pin 8 is VCC. It is responsible for supplying the power to the IC. Let's set up the circuit step by step. Start by placing the 555 timer IC onto the breadboard. Remember, the pins are numbered counterclockwise, starting from the top left. Refer to the later circuit diagram if you have questions about the circuit connections. Insert the 555 timer in the middle of the breadboard. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2 or trigger to pin 6 or threshold. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 4 or reset to pin 8 or VCC. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Now take the second 555 timer and place it in the center of the breadboard, just below the first one. Repeat the same jumper wire setup on the second 555 timer. Insert a 1 microfarad capacitor into pin 2 or trigger in the negative rail. The anode is in pin 2. Insert a 0.1 microfarad capacitor into pin 2 or trigger in the negative rail of the second 555 timer. Since ceramic capacitors don't have polarity, you can insert either leg into pin 2 without any issues. Bend the ends of a 220 kilo ohm resistor. Insert the 220 kilo ohm resistor into pin 3, or output, and pin 6, or threshold. Bend the ends of a 2.2 kilo ohm resistor. Insert the 2.2 kilo ohm resistor into pin 3, or output in pin 6, or threshold of the second 555 timer. Bend the ends of a 22 kilo ohm resistor. Insert the 22 kilo ohm resistor into pin 3 of the first 555 timer and pin 2 of the second one. Insert a 10 microfarad capacitor into pin 3 of the second 555 timer and a few rows below it. The anode is in pin 3. insert a jumper wire in the same row as the 10 microfarad capacitor. Attach the alligator clip to the other end of the jumper wire. Insert a jumper wire into the negative rail. Attach the alligator clip to the other end of the jumper wire. Attach the other ends of the alligator clips to the 5-watt speaker. Attach the buckle connector to the 9-volt battery. It's time to connect the power supply. Connect the positive lead of the battery holder to the positive rail. Connect the negative lead of the battery holder to the negative rail. We have successfully completed the circuit. Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. This is a Hee Haw Siren circuit built using two 555 timer ICs. The design generates a two-tone siren sound often heard in emergency vehicles. The core of the circuit relies on the astable configuration of the 555 timers to modulate frequencies and create a warbling audio tone. The first 555 timer is configured as a low-frequency oscillator. It uses a 220,000 ohm resistor and a 1 microfarad capacitor to set its frequency. This IC produces a slow oscillating waveform at its output, or pin 3, which is fed into the control circuitry of the second 555 timer. The output from IC 1 passes through a 22,000 ohm resistor to modulate the voltage level at pin 2, or trigger and pin 6, or threshold, influencing its oscillation rate. The 555 timer is configured as a high-frequency oscillator responsible for producing the audible tone. It uses a 2,200 ohm resistor and a 100 nanofarad capacitor to set the frequency range. When modulated by the first 555 output, the frequency of the second 555 varies, creating the rising and falling hee-haw siren effect. The final output from the second 555 pin 3 drives the speaker through 10 microfarad capacitor, which blocks DC and allows only the AC audio signal to pass. Power is supplied by a 9-volt battery, and both ICs share the same power and ground lines. The result is a classic alternating siren sound, generated by frequency modulation between the two 555 timers. I hope this video has shown you how to make a hee-haw siren with 555 timer ICs. Want to dive deeper into 555 timer projects? Grab my free ebook packed with awesome circuits and ideas. Just click the link in the description to download your copy now. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.